Welcome back, my friends. So we have graduated from exploring linear equations and linear systems to matrices. So here we are going to look at matrices in significant more detail, as well as exploring their amazing properties and applications. So to get us started, we need to start with matrix operations. So algebraic operations with matrices. Now, this is going to enhance our ability to analyze and solve linear systems. So get excited, get ready, here we go. So to begin, I want to do just a little general review of the standard notation for an M by N matrix A, as well as to establish some new vocabulary. Now, in particular, I'd like to start here by pointing out an important row and an important column. The important row is the ith row, and the important column here is the jth column. So in many proofs, we can verify that a property is going to hold true using the ith jth entry of the intersection of this row and column. And this is important because this row and column are arbitrary. So if this property holds true in an arbitrary case, it's going to hold true for all cases. So these two, well, this row and this column are important for you to keep in mind. Now, with that being said, let's think about the ith jth entry. So the ith jth entry is the scalar entry in the ith row and jth column. This is the scalar entry in the ith row and jth column. And we can see this highlighted above. So this is denoted as A sub ij. The next thing I want to point out to you is an alternative way to think about the matrix A here. And that's by considering the columns of matrix A. So we already know that a matrix can be thought of as a collection of column vectors. So we can say that our matrix A, our M by N matrix A, can be thought of as a collection of column vectors. So this is an equivalent alternative notation. And we can say that this is our matrix A whose column vectors are defined as vector A sub 1, vector A sub 2, all the way that we have somewhere in here the jth column vector. And then we continue all the way to that nth column vector, A sub n. Now another important feature of a matrix are the entries along the diagonal, or the diagonal entries. So the diagonal entries are simply the scalar entries that form the main diagonal. So the scalar entries that form the main diagonal. And so let's highlight some of these diagonal entries. We have the entry A sub 1, 1. We have the entry A sub 2, 2. We have the entry A sub 3, 3, A sub 4, 4. Somewhere in here we have that ith jth entry. We continue all the way till we get to that last diagonal entry, A sub m, n. Beautiful! So these diagonal entries are important. If we have what's known as a diagonal matrix, this implies a square N by N matrix, whose non-diagonal entries are zero. So this is a square, so N by N matrix, whose non-diagonal entries are all zero. Can you think of an important diagonal matrix that we work frequently with? The identity matrix, woo! So an example of a diagonal matrix is the identity matrix. So the identity matrix being that that square matrix whose main diagonal entries are 1 and all non-diagonal entries are 0. Now with 0 in mind, we have our last new vocab, the 0 matrix. And I bet you can guess what this matrix is. It is an M by N matrix whose entries are all 0. Woo! So this is an M by N matrix whose entries are all 0.